father and daughter. Both of the international is a non-profit educational organization, the club of the world. The mission of Toastmaster International to empower individuals to become effective communicators and become a leader. The club was started in the year 1924, a founder was Dr. Manny. The code of conduct, Toastmaster meeting. Number one, please switch off your head and phone if you are putting it in the channel. Number two, do not walk around during the meeting. Please use the suit of paper to communicate across the hall. Number three, we encourage members to come in a glad and formal manner. Number four, speech are different from taboo topics like sex, religion, and politics. Now, this is the time for presiding officer. He is a IT advisor and president of the medical. Please put hands together. Our presiding officer, Toastmaster Mohan.
Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon. See, a person wants to go from point A to point B. For some reason, you don't want you to reach point B. What will you do?
Obstacles. Who's an obstacle?
Obstacles, okay. So point A to point B, you don't want him to reach point B. So this is a problem he poses in the workshop. So one of the things you can do is create a point C, which is more attractive for him, so that he does not go to point B. So in both the workshops, coincidentally, he covered this problem. Of course, second workshop, I knew the answer. I can say it used to be a huge few hundred people attending the workshop. But it really didn't, it taught me something. These are the fundamentals of personal relationship building and negotiation. Whatever you do, it's all about creating something more attractive for the person to move. If you have read the Dale Carnegie's book, How to Make Friends and Influence People, it's one of the classics on negotiation. Though the title does not say negotiation, it's one of the classics on negotiation, where he talks about looking at other person's perspective, make things interesting for that person. About 10 years back, I was in Singapore on a vacation and we were going on a night safari. How many of you have taken the night safari in Singapore? So you go in a train and then you can, on one side you can see all the animals. On a rock, highly, maybe a man-made rock, right, at a high place, there was a huge lion. It looked very artificial to me. I never seen such a big lion sitting there. So for a moment it didn't move. I thought it was a statue, but it was a lion. There was some movement before the train moved. Across the spot, I could see the lion move a little. So it was actually definitely a live animal. But after the train ride, I was thinking, how come the lion is going to sit there? There are going to be hours of train rides going on. Are they changing the line? Or are they doing something? How is the lion going to stay in the rock? What if the lion doesn't? So people won't miss the chance of watching the single lion there. Do you know how it happens? It's all about making something attractive for the lion. It's all about creating a point C. They maintain the temperature of the rock so nice and warm, so the lion chooses to sit there most of the time. There's no pressure, just the rock has been made a point C for the lion. So friends, it's all about making or creating something more attractive, no pressure. You can just move through your personal relationships or office relationship or tough negotiations as seamlessly as you can. So welcome to meeting number 367.
I have declared the meeting open. So all the Brahmani are watching. Alexa, you can manage some more. So before we hit the meeting trial, can we get some guest introductions, please? For the guests here. Can you please introduce yourself?
They said, whatever we send, you use your own version of it, so we're not going to send you any more reproductions. But I had to persuade, I got one liner from Kalyan. He says he's still work in progress. But all of us know he's a very dynamic guy. He was a contest chair for Ovation. Middle East Ovation, Middle East Club Contest. And it was spotless. Extremely dynamic person. We can easily see how he keeps in pace with the extras in WhatsApp. Right? He's the only guy who is 40 plus. He's able to keep pace with Arjun, Janani, and Gopika. Amazing. I'm sure Alex will agree. So, welcome, Kalyan, on stage.